Today's topic is types of keys in DBMS. Every time you are learning the normal form and other things, you have heard about the keys. Even in ER diagram, I told many times this is the primary key, this is the non-key. Even I have explained you what is primary key, what is foreign key. But this is in brief. Those who haven't understood the concept, they can learn from this concept. So today I'm going to explain you primary key, candidate key, alternate key, and super key. Okay, let's see one by one. So key is also an attribute, or we can say a set of attribute which is going to identify the row in a relationship. The keys are defined in a table to access or sequence the stored data quickly and smoothly. So using a single or the combination of keys, you can identify the rows of table. So there are various type of keys: primary key, candidate key, super key, alternate key, and composite key. So first is primary key. Suppose I'm having table employee, in which I'm having fields like employee ID, employee name, social security number, department ID, and date of birth. So there are, we can say, we have to select a column which is unique, and it can have, it can't have null value. Is the column you choose to maintain the uniqueness in a table at row level. Here in employee table, you can say that there are two columns which you can make as a primary key. The first column is employee ID and the second column is social security number. So these are the two columns which value is not null and which value is unique. So this you can take as a primary key. I have already told you that if I'm having student table, student enrollment number, name, address, city, state, zip code, marks. So from that, we can take student enrollment number as a primary key. Because it is unique, it differs from student to student. No two students in the Indus University who are having same primary key. So this you can take as a primary key because it is unique and it is not null. Every student are having their enrollment number. Okay. So here in this table, you can see that employee ID, which is a unique value, which is not null, and social security number, like PAN card, like Aadhaar card. So this is when employee is having that social security number, which is unique and as well as it is not null. So these two columns you can take as a primary key, but employee ID is a preferable choice. So employee ID you can take as a primary key. Primary key is also called candidate key. From the available candidate key, you can choose one key as a primary key, which is going to identify all the entities of that relationship. So this is the primary key. In ER diagram, you can show primary key by drawing the underline. Ideally, we can say that primary key consists of only one attribute. But it is possible to have multiple primary keys in one attribute. We can say more than one attribute, possible to have multiple primary keys. So to define a field as a primary key, you have to see the following condition, whether it is going to meet or not. The first condition, no two rows can have same primary key value. Every row must have a primary key value. The primary key field cannot be null. Value in a primary key column can never be modified or updated if any foreign key refers to that primary key, right? So its value is, we can say unique plus not null plus no two rows are having same or duplicate value, and you cannot update or change that value. It will remain as it is. I can't change country code even if I want. I can't change city's pin code even if I want. Because these are the value which is uniquely defined worldwide, so you can't change it. The next key is a candidate key. So are individual columns in a table that qualifies For the uniqueness of each row and tuple, here in the employee table, employee ID and social security number are eligible for the primary key. So these are the candidate keys. From the candidate keys, we are selecting the primary key. And candidate keys are the super key, which has no proper subset, is a super key. In other words, the candidate key is a minimal super key. I'll let you know the difference between minimal and minimum. I'll show you an example how we can find out minimal and how we can find out minimum. The candidate key is a minimal of super key. So here we can take that employee ID and SSN number from the given candidate keys. You can select one as the primary key and the remaining key will call as alternate key. Suppose from employee ID and SSN number, if I select employee ID as a primary key, then you can see that SSN number is my alternate key. Okay, so if one you have selected, then other will known as an alternate key. Okay, so candidate key is also that key. Using that candidate key or combination of that candidate key, you can identify all other attributes. From employee ID, you can identify other attributes. From social security number, you can identify other attributes. So these are the, we can say, candidate keys using which you can find out the other rows of relation. And one key from that candidate key, we can select as a primary key. And if I select one key as a primary key, then the remaining key is known as the alternate key. Employee ID is my primary key, then SSN number is my alternate key. Okay, now super key. If you add any other column or attribute to a primary key, then it becomes a super key. Again, super key is also going to identify all the attributes of your table uniquely, right? All the rows of your table uniquely. But super key is the combination of the primary key plus any other key. Suppose I'm taking employee ID and combined with employee name, then also I'm going to identify all other attributes. If I'm combining department ID with employee ID, then also I'll identify all the attributes. Any of this, any of two, any of three, any of four, I'm combined with this employee ID primary key, then it will become a super key. See, super, all the keys are super key. When I combine that super key with primary key or any key with primary key, then it becomes super key because that combination will definitely give me all the attributes uniquely. For example, if I combine, if I take student ID or student enrollment number as a primary key, right? So from student enrollment number, I can identify all the students or information of all the students. For example, I'm having enrollment number of any of the student, Riva or something, Riya of your class. I'm having enrollment number of Riya. Then I can see that I will definitely identify all other attributes of that particular student Riya, right? Now suppose I can take enrollment number plus name Riya, then also I can identify enrollment number of Riya plus date of birth of Riya, then also I can identify enrollment number of Riya plus department IT of Riya, then also I can identify. So using that primary key, I can add any of the non-key attribute, then I'll get the all the information regarding that particular student or that particular employee from that table. So that combination with the primary key, any of the key combination, whether it is single key, two keys, three keys, many keys you can take. So that is known as a super key. So super key is a set of one or more attributes that are taken collectively and can identify all other attributes uniquely. Okay, now composite key. Employee composite key means if a table do have single column that qualifies for the candidate key, then you have to select two or more columns to make a row unique. If there is no employee ID or SSN column, then you can make employee name plus date of birth as a composite primary key. But still there can be a narrow chance of duplication. Composite key means what? You can take any combination other than the primary key, or we can say suppose employee ID or SSN number is not present in this table. So which combination you can take, using that you can identify all the rows uniquely. That combination is known as a composite key. Suppose I can take employee name and date of birth. So that composite, that is known as a composite primary key. And there is a narrow chances of duplication also, because the student are having same name as well as same date of birth. So this kind of key is known as a composite key. Employee ID and we can say a combination of SSN is also known as a composite ID. Any combination you are taking and getting all the attribute of that particular table. If it is not that, in that case, you can take the combination of employee name and date of birth. Now, foreign key, this is a bit difficult concept to understand for the student, but let me explain you in an easy manner. Okay. For example, this is the department table, and department table is having department having department ID as a primary key, and employee table is having employee ID as a primary key, right? This table is having this primary key, and this table is having this primary key. But for employee information, we are even writing department ID also, that this employee belongs to this department. So primary key of one table will become the foreign key of the other table, which will show the relationship between two tables. If I can give you a real-time simple example of you guys, for example, student ID is the primary key for the student table, and I can say that book ID is the primary key for the book table. But whenever you want to take book from the library, what you are going to give? Either your enrollment number or your library card, and which that is your enrollment number. For example, using your enrollment number, you can issue the book from the library, right? So that enrollment number will now become a foreign key for the book table, because book table is having their own primary key, that is the book ID. But enrollment number of student I'm using over there. For example, if you can go for fees section and you want to pay the fees, right? So in that case, you can see that in fees table, there is one fees receipt number, that is the primary key for the fees table. But student is paying the fees, so student has to give the enrollment number. But that enrollment number is the, we can say, primary key for the student table. But that enrollment number we are referring for paying fees also. But fees table is having receipt number as a primary key. So that enrollment number of student is now become a foreign key for that fees table. So whenever it is going to show the relationship between two tables, master table and detail table, parent table and child table, then this relationship shown by the foreign key, that key will become primary key of one table, will become the foreign key for the other table. And this is required actually, because if I am making the software of Indus University, then I have to take student enrollment number as a primary key in student table and foreign key for the other tables. Next is unique key. Now there is again a question that what is the difference between the unique key and the primary key? This is the question generally arise during the interviews, that unique key is also unique, primary key is also unique. They both are not allowing duplicate values. Then what is the difference between the primary key and unique key? The main difference between primary key and unique key is unique key can be null, but primary key can never allow null values. So this is the major difference between the primary key and unique key. Unique key, you can take that email ID as a unique key, because your email ID is, we can say, different from person to person. But one person doesn't have their email ID. There are employees in a university or who doesn't, some of the people doesn't have their own email ID. That is going to happen. If some new person is there, then he is having his employee ID. Once he entered into the university, joined the job, he was going to get his employee ID, but maybe he doesn't have email ID, he will going to join later on, right? Email ID he will going to get later on. So email ID is unique. It is different from person to person, but that is the thing. Email ID can be a null. Unique key can be a null, but primary key cannot be null. Now there is one practical exam. You can see here, there is one table given. Actually, why this is going to happen, I don't know. Okay. You can see here the table A, B, C, D, E. This is the attributes given in the relation, and the dependencies are given. A tends to B, C, D, E. Because if I take this, means A tends to A itself will come, A, B, C, D, E. So you will going to get A, B, C, D, E, all the attributes of this table. This is given. So A you can tell as a uniquely determine the other attributes. These two are the given. B, C tends to ABE. So if I put BC here, so ABCDE. So you can see that again BC is BC, B and C jointly determine all the attributes in the relationship. So this is the table given to you. These are the functional dependencies given to you. Now you have to find out the primary key, candidate key, super key, and composite key. Okay, what is the primary key here? You can say that, madam, A is the primary key here, right? Because primary key we are taking as a single attribute, only one column we are taking as a primary key. So I'm taking here A. From A, I'm deriving A, B, C, D, and E. I'm taking closer. Now, what is candidate key here? Candidate key can be any combination of going to identify all the attributes of that table. So here the combination is already given to us. So A and B, C are the combination using which we can identify all the other attributes. We have to even find out the other attributes which is going to identify the all the attributes uniquely, but there is no other combination is given to us. Now, what are the super key? I told you that any key you can combine with the primary key and it will become super key. Primary key is A, so I can combine A. BC is possible primary key, so BC is also super key. If I combine E with the A, then also you are going to get all the attributes, right? So AE, AD, ABC, if you are combining all these things from the dependency, you are going to get the all column. You can derive all the column. So all this combination is called super key. Now composite key. If primary key A is not present, in that case, you can find out the combination using which you can identify all other keys. So that combination is BC, which using which you can identify the other combination, all other rows. So this is called BC. This is the composite key, right? Today I'm going to end the session here. And if you are having any queries, any question, you can ask me. Or do you have any questions?